Yes, students, I'm sorry, I had muted it. Before moving on with the class, I would like to ask whether there are any doubts or any clarifications required in the previous classes which have been conducted. Any doubts or any clarifications? Nayana? Nayana? Are you there, Nayana?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you have watched the videos, previous videos? Yeah, Naina, you have watched the previous videos?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts, any clarifications required?
No, ma'am.
Okay, any other student require any clarification? Please ask now. Purnima? Purnima? Any clarification? Okay.
No, ma'am.
Great. So I can go ahead with the class right now. Okay. So here, my dear students, if you could see here. Human resource competency model. Okay, so here when we speak about the competencies required for the human resource manager here, so I've just classified it into four categories. One is the HR manager should have business mastery, should have personal credibility, should be a HR master, as well as a change mastery. Okay, so when we speak about business mastery, he or she should be very much well versed with the business environment, okay, very much well versed with the business acumen, okay, and should know the ins and outs of the business. That is very much required. Apart from that, the customer orientation, okay, so here the HRs also have to be in touch with the customers, understand the psychology of the customers, okay, and understand the needs of the customers, and the same information is to be passed on to the marketing department. Okay, apart from that, external relations, right? So relations with the local authorities, that is panchayat offices, okay, relations with the labor welfare departments, relationship with the various government departments, relationship with the police departments, and all those things. So here external relations are to be well versed with the HR department, and the HR manager should know how to handle these relations. Okay, so that's what we say business mastery. Apart from that, personal credibility here should have should create trust among people. So the top management as well as the lower level management, all the employees of the organization should trust the HR manager. Then only things will be smooth and easy to handle. Okay, that is one thing which the HR manager has to build in within the organization, right? So apart from that, you have personal relationships, right? So HR has to see to it that they know each and every individual by name within the organization. They know the family status of the individuals within the organization. They know everything about the employee in the organization. So usually certain companies, what they do, they visit the homes of the employees or in the organization, and then they speak to their family members, see to it that they look into the welfare of the family members as well as for the employee. Okay, then lived values. Yes, whatever the HR speaks, first he or she has to live that. Okay, so here I cannot simply ask the employees to implement the things whereas I myself have not implemented it, right? So here I should be an example. That is, the HR manager should be an example for all the employees for the values which are being put forth in the organization. Apart from that, should be very courageous, right? That is one of the personal credibility which should be required by an HR manager. Should be very courageous. Okay, now why this courage is required is, many a times there will be strikes, there will be lockdowns within the organization, there will be a lot of problems, conflicts arising within the organization. So in that particular point of time, HR is the first point of contact. Okay, so n number of times HRs will be put in trouble. Okay, so HR manager has to take a decision. Many a times the top management withdraws, putting the entire responsibility on the HR manager. So HR manager has to take a decision wherein the HR manager has to look into that the organization also is not in loss, as well as the employee also is not in loss. You do not lose your employees as well as you keep the trust of top management with you. So that is one thing which we say the courage is required to take certain decisions within the organization. So that personal credibility is required. Apart from that, you have HR mastery. Okay, so here, my dear students, when we speak about HR mastery, the HR manager should be very much well versed with various terms of HR, that is staffing, the human resource planning, staffing, recruitment, right? Then selection of the candidate, then performance appraisal of the candidate, training and development of the candidate, and putting forth a very best reward system, motivating reward system in the organization, communication within the organization, design of the organization, structure of the organization, building the culture within the organization. All these are various HR mastery which the HR manager has to have. Okay. Apart from that, a very, very important aspect which is required for HR managers is change mastery. Okay. So here HR is being seen as a change agent. We have already seen in the last classes, my dear students, the roles of HR managers, right? So in that, the last role was change agent. So HR is being seen as a change agent. So any change which is to be injected within the organization should start with the HR department. Okay. So HR manager has to see to it that he motivates people, he trains people, and he sees to it that the change is being implemented positively within the organization by the people. Okay. So for that, what are the skills required? One is interpersonal skills and influential skills. So HR manager should have interpersonal skills. That means he should be in touch with the employees continuously. Okay. I think some students want to join. Okay. So here what happens is interpersonal skill is very much required. Okay. So here HR has to be in communication with all the employees within the organization, right from the housekeeping to the managerial departments. Everyone need to be in contact with the HR department or the HR manager. Okay. So here interpersonal skill is very much required. So when you are continuously in touch with people, there is a trust which is being built between you and the employees within the organization. So whatever you say or whatever the HR manager say, positively the employees will start implementing it. Okay. So they get influenced by the HR manager. So that type of role model or that type of leadership skills should be there with the HR manager. That is one of the skill required, interpersonal skills and influencing skills. Okay. So basically when I started with the HR job, my dear students, every day I was required, because I was into compliance, so I was required to go into the departments, speak to people, understand each and every individual's needs, wants, problems and all those things, and then come back, analyze it and sort out and identify solutions for those problems, right? That was the first job which was being given to me as into compliance, right? HR compliance. So here, my dear students, that is the first skill which is required, interpersonal skills and influencing skills. And then you have the second skill which is required for change mastery, that is problem solving skills, right? So whenever you are implementing a change, the change is not being welcomed by the employees in the organization, right? So immediately they will not welcome it, but later on when you start training them, motivating them, they will surely implement that particular change depending on the leadership qualities of the HR manager. So here there will be lot of issues, lot of problems which will be created in the phase of introduction as well as in the phase of implementing that particular change to the employees. So that time what happens is you have to see to it that you solve those problems in a positive way so that the change is being implemented positively by the employees. Okay. So that problem solving skill is very much required. Apart from that, reward system, you need to see to it that you set up a very nice reward system, motivating reward system, which will give motivation for the employees to implement the change. And obviously you have the change mastery, the last skill which is required, innovativeness and creativeness. Every time when the change is being implemented within the organization, you cannot have the same mode of communication. You cannot have the same mode of convincing. You cannot have the same mode of influencing and all those things. You need to be very creative as a manager. You need to be very innovative as a manager for putting forth the information in front of the employees so that they accept it in a positive way. That is what required. So these are the various skills which are required by human resource. Okay. And this is what we say, human resource competency model. Now moving on to a very nice survey here. In a recent survey of Indian CEOs, So Indian managerial leaders were less dependent on their personal charisma. Okay. So here there was a survey which was being done of Indian CEOs. Okay. So here what happened is they identified that the managers of India, okay, Indian leaders or the managers or CEOs, they were not so much dependent on their personal charisma. That means they did not give too much of importance for the personal looks or charisma or the smile or the aura which is being built. Apart from that, they also were less dependent on emphasized logical. That means logical thinking was somewhere lacking, and step-by-step implementation of the process also was somewhere lacking. That was the study which was being conducted, and they identified that these were the lacking things which of the Indian managers. But now, basically, Indian managers focus more on empowerment. Okay. So here, the Indian managers or Indian leaders or CEOs, okay, or the managers or general managers, HR, everything. So all these Indian leaders basically focused on empowerment and accountability. Now, accountability is one word which has got a lot of focus right now. Okay. So your empowerment is giving powers to your employees. Okay. Giving freedom to your employees to work in their own way. Giving responsibility to the employees to work in their own way. So that's what we say empowerment. Okay. So here Indian leaders basically focused on this empowerment as well as accountability. Okay. In case of critical situations like turnaround challenges, innovative technology, product planning, marketing ideologies, all these are various critical situations wherein the Indian leaders focus more on giving powers to the employees, giving freedom to the employees, giving responsibility to the employees, as well giving the accountability to the employees. So that was the survey being done, and in this this was the result of this particular survey. So apart from that, there are various key HRM practices in Indian organizations, right? So here, basically, when we speak about HRM practices in Indian organization, so work roles is very high in public sector. So when you speak about public sector, so too much of emphasis or importance is given to work roles. Okay. So here too much of strong dependency is there on formal labor market. Okay. So they depend too much on the formal labor market. Direct recruitment will be there when it comes to public sector. You could have seen many of the public sectors like ONGC and all those things. They put forth the advertisement in the newspaper directly. The resumes are being received, shortlisting, and they have various rounds which are being conducted, and finally this candidate is being selected. So there is direct recruitment, okay, from the various sources, okay, but they recruit more from the institutions of higher learning. Okay, so what they do is they just go in that is the second source of the recruitment, that is through the newspapers, but first source which they identify is through the institutions, right? So directly they will be recruiting the students from the institutions, right? Apart from that, as I said, placement agencies, internet, print media, that is newspapers. So public sectors basically depend more on campus recruitment from the institutions as well as print media, more on print media rather than on placement agencies. They do not depend too much on placement agencies. But apart from that, the third mode of the third source of recruitment would be internet. Okay, through internet they recruit. They have their own websites. So they put forth the vacancies in their websites, and directly you can place your resumes in the websites. Okay, so that's what is the work role of public sectors. Basically, they focus more on the work role. They want people who can, run this process of the organization in a very smooth way. Okay. Apart from that, public sectors, obviously, it is a lifetime employment. Government sectors and public sectors, we look into as a lifetime employment in India, which include a lot of range of facilities like healthcare, housing, schooling for children. Too many facilities are there, right? Apart from that, if you could see training and development and career planning, basically that is being focused more into private sectors. Okay. So private sectors give too much of importance for training and development as well as career planning for their employees, because they want to retain their employees. They cannot give too many facilities to their employees as the public sector gives. But here they want to retain their employees. So they focus more on training and development of the employees as well as career planning of the employees. As well, they look into the performance appraisal, promotion and reward system within the organization. Okay. So this is all the picture of what HRM of public and private sectors in India. So moving on down to HRM challenges. Okay. So here, first challenge, that is environmental challenge. Okay. So here, if you could see, when we speak about environmental challenges, fast and frequent changes. So as I said, if you do not change, you don't remain in the market. Okay. So if you could see, so many products keep on changing, right? So n number of branded products also, they have a lot of changes being put forth into it. Why they have to do it? Just because to remain competitive or remain number one in the market. Okay. So that's what we say. Not many changes happen, okay? Fast changes are happening. With the wink of an eye, things change, okay? So here, when changes happen, as HR plays a role of change agent, he or she has to be very fast in implementing that change within the organization, okay? So it may be change in the policies, it may be change in the procedures, it may be change in the processes, it may be change in the strategies, okay? Everything, okay? So everything has to keep on changing. So recruitment strategies or performance appraisal strategies or maybe training and development strategies, everything has to keep on changing. Fast and quick changes should be included depending on the situations. That is the biggest challenge when it comes to the HR department. Apart from that, technological development and internet revolution, okay? So too many development in the technologies. With the wink of an eye, technology keeps on changing, okay? Every now and then you have new technologies coming up, okay? So with that, what happens, there will be a lot of changes which will be happening in the organization. So you have to prepare your employees to adapt or implement those changes, okay? And you have to make sure that the employees abide by the rules, regulations, discipline, order of the, or decorum of the organization, okay? So all these are various challenges. Apart from the internet revolution, okay, so here, my dear students, more of the HRs are dependent on the technology. And anyhow, in India, probably it is not so much into consideration because the law wants certain things to be, maintained in the book itself. Okay, there are various books of which are being maintained within the HR department, like must rule and all those things, right? So apart from that, when we speak about various other things like recruitment or maybe performance appraisal or training and all those things, that is entirely, there are a lot of changes which have happened in that particular field. Okay, so here HR analytics is one of the field which has been introduced long back and implemented right now and got it importance right now in India. Okay, so all the organizations have their own software systems, right? So everything is monitored in that particular software system. So it becomes a challenge for the HR department to maintain the secrecy of the things, okay, as well as learn the new things and become very creative and innovative. Okay, so now HRs cannot be traditional HRs. They have to be, innovative. They have to be creative. They have to be they have to come out with new strategies every now and then, okay, and then only they can remain in the market. So that is one of the challenge. Apart from that, workforce diversity, because of globalization, okay, you have diverse workforce working in your organization, you have different age people working in your organization, different gender people working in your organization, different caste, creed, culture people working in your organization, different country people working in your organization, and that becomes the biggest challenge because when we speak about different country people working under one roof, one common language would be English. Apart from that, there are some countries which do not speak English also. Okay, they stress more on their local language. Okay, so how do you see to it that these people, okay, who come from various countries, work together, okay, under one particular roof for the development of the organization? Now that becomes a challenge for the human resource management or human resource department. Apart from that, the other challenges is gender difference. Okay, you have senior people in the organization as well as you have fresh blood, the junior people within the organization. How do you see to it that they coordinate with each other, they cooperate with each other and work towards the growth of the organization? Now that becomes again a biggest challenge. Apart from that, you have skill shortage, right? So here, that is one of the problem which prevails in India, right? Because the Indian government or maybe there are so many lacunas in the government policies and all those things, right? Or maybe into the organization. So they do not identify the skill sets which are there, and ultimately the skills, whatever the skilled people whoever are there in India, they move out to other countries, and then they come out with their skills there. That particular ground for development of their skill is being given in various other countries, but it is not given in India. And that is one of the negative point which is there in India. Okay, so here what happens is you face a lot of skill shortage. You will not find too many skilled employees, okay, because you are not ready to pay more. Okay, so lot many problems are there. Okay, so HR department has to see to it that within these limitations, how do you acquire or how do you recruit skilled people within the organization? Okay, that is what one of the challenge which is faced by HR department. Apart from that, work life balance, again, as I said, HR have to involve when it comes to domestic HRM, my dear students, when the industry is only domestic, in the sense operating within India, so too much of interference of HR will not be there with the family members, right? So when it comes to international human resource management, okay, so that time the HR has to involve in the family life of the employee also. He has to take care of the employees, right? So if you are sending any employee from here to another country or deploying him for certain work there, so that time what happens is you have to look into the family members of the employee whom you have sent. Okay, again, schooling facilities, healthcare facilities, and all those things should be given. Apart from that, you have to also safeguard the life as well as safeguard the interest of the employee who is being sent there. And in case it is for a longer period of time, maybe for 4 years, 5 years, 6 years or something like that, you're sending an employee to the other countries, that time you have to also send the family of the employee there, see to the adjustments of the family, see to the accommodation of the family, schooling facilities for the children, healthcare facilities for the elder people within the family. Okay, a lot many interferences will be there. So that's what we say, work-life balance. Okay, see to it that you look into the family members and get the better performance from the employee. You motivate the employee. Okay, so you also see the welfare of the employee as well as welfare of the family members when it comes to international HRM. So when it comes to domestic HRM, okay, so there are a lot of issues when it comes to work life. Okay, many a times it happens that in IT companies, husband will be working in morning shift and wife will be working in the night shift. So a lot of conflicts which take place between them because there is no understanding, their communication gap will be there. Okay, so here what happens is many IT companies, what they do is when they get married, they put the husband and wife in the same shift. Okay, so that their family life is also not disturbed as well as their work life and their performance within the work life also is not being disturbed. So that is what we say. Okay, work-life balance. Many a times it happens that night shift, okay, and again the health factors do come into consideration. Okay, so how do you see to it that as a HR, help the employee in balancing his work and life? Okay, that is also one of the challenge which comes down to HR. Apart from that, my dear students, rise of service sectors. Okay, so a lot many service sectors which have risen, NGOs and all those things, right? So how do you see to it that you put forth certain services to the society also? And then a lot of government interventions, obviously, a lot of changes in the labor laws, a lot of changes in the economic situations. Many a times, suddenly the government may announce that you have to recruit at least 50% of SCST or 50% of other caste people within the organization, or 50% of disabled people within the organization. Sudden announcement will be there, you have to change your strategy. Okay, how do you deal with all these challenges, right? So that is one of the challenge which comes down to HR. Apart from that, the second challenge which comes down to HR department is organizational challenges. That is labor cost. Many a times what happens is the demand for the labor will be high, okay, and the supply of labor will be very low. Okay, so you will have very low skilled number of skilled people who can take up the jobs in the organization. So that time the demand of the job will be very high. So what happens is employees who will be joining the organization will obviously demand higher pay. Okay, so you cannot lose the employee also because you want to recruit skilled people in your organization. As well, you cannot give the demanded salary to the employee. So in that case, how do you negotiate with the employee? Okay, that becomes one of the challenge of HRM. Okay, understanding the labor cost. Okay, limiting the cost. Okay, cutting the cost and all those things do come into consideration. Apart from that, quality. Okay. Maintaining quality hires within the organization. Okay, so here many challenges comes when it comes to recruitment. Okay, because the organizations do not provide too much of funds for recruitment, and salary issues will be there, promotion issues. Okay, so here if you want best candidate, you have to pay the best salary. So how do you see to it that you implement the strategies in such a way that you maintain the quality of hire within the organization? That is one of the challenge of HRM. Apart from that, you have innovation. As I said, you need to innovate. You need to keep on changing your strategies of HR within the organization. You need to be very creative in order to get the competent people within the organization or retain competent people within the organization. Then you have self-managed teams. Okay, so you have to build a team culture within the organization. See to these teams are self-managed. Okay, and make them the leaders. Okay, so creating the leaders, training the leaders. Okay, all these are various challenges which do come in HR department. Okay, then you have the organizational culture, building the organization culture. So whenever we think about taking up a job in a particular organization, first thing which we look into is culture of the organization. Okay, how employees are treated within the organization, what ethics or what culture the employees follow within the organization. Okay, how it is being seen in the society, how the company is being seen in the society. Okay, all these are various things which do come into consideration. So building the organization culture is a big challenge for HR department. Okay, so apart from that, outsourcing. Okay, certain times you have to outsource certain things. Okay, it may be various functions of HR or various functions of various the other departments. So HR has to see to it that the secrecy is being maintained, as well as you outsource whatever is required only and minimize the cost. Okay, that is one of the thing which is to be looked in when it comes to outsourcing. Downsizing, certain times you have to remove the employees from your organization. Okay, whenever there is some problem with the organization, whenever there is loss faced by the organization, to cut down the cost, you try to remove the employees in the organization. So which employees you'll be removing after you remove the employees, after you downsize? When again you are coming, your organization starts growing, that time again how you are going to recruit, how you are going to maintain the goodwill of the organization in the market, that becomes again a challenge. Then you have decentralization, my dear students. Okay, so many of the organizations go for decentralization rather than centralization. So you have virtual organization system here, if you could remember your MOB syllabus here. So one particular person will be sitting in India, another person will be sitting in Australia, another person will be sitting in America or whatever it is, and they communicate with each other. Okay, and then basically when it comes to decentralization, the power and authority is being given individually to all the country people, right? So wherever the branches are there, the power and authority is being given. There is no centralization. Okay, only the culture is being followed, but the decisions can be taken by the branch offices. That is what we say decentralization. So major decisions may be taken by the head office, but other decisions can be taken by the branch office located in various other countries. Then again, you say technological advancement. Okay, so when it comes to production system, many a times when it comes to technological advancement, you just go into bringing in new machineries and all those things. So you have to make your employees train your employees on the new machines, make them accept the change, and then start working on those new machines, like artificial intelligence, digitalization, technology of HR processes, all those things, right? Then capability gaps. Okay, so here skill sets will be there with the organization HR department. Each and every employee skill, knowledge, ability, okay, all the record will be there at the HR department. So how do you utilize it? That becomes the biggest challenge, okay, for the growth of the organization. Apart from that, the next challenge is individual challenges. Okay, so first individual challenge of HR department is brain drain. Okay, so many a times it happens that you do not use the capability of the individuals within the organization. Okay, so ultimately what happens is you are just, you know, not utilizing the intelligence of the employees in the organization. It keeps on draining. Okay, so that should not happen. So how do you see to it that you utilize the skills or the intellectual things of intellectual of the employees in your organization? That is the biggest challenge. Okay, so many organizations fail in this, right? Apart from that, job insecurity, all the employees within the organization, on this particular term, job security is nowhere existing. Okay, so only thing is you perform, you stay in the organization. You don't perform, the next day you are kicked out from the organization. So here, there is no job security at all. So all the employees within the organization, they face this dilemma, okay, whether their job is secure or no. Okay, so here, a lot of job insecurity will be there. And because of that, many a times employees go into depression, they get demotivated, and they get into argument with the officers, the immediate boss, supervisors, whatever it is, right? And that should not happen. Okay, you see to it that as a HR department, okay, you cannot guarantee them the job, but you can also give an assurance that if you are really performing well, your job will be really secure within the organization. That communication should be passed on to the employees. Okay, so that's what is one of the problem which happens. Okay, so many of the employees leave because of the job's insecurity, because of the brain drain. Okay, so you may lose better employees there. So that should not happen. That is the one challenge which the HR department faces. Apart from that, productivity, okay, saying to the limitations, taking the consideration of limitations of the top management, okay, you see to it that you motivate the employees in such a way that they are, you know, positive as well as they are productive within the organization. They become loyal towards the organization in spite of the limitations which are there of the top management. Okay, so that is one of the challenge of HR department. So that can be taken into consideration only when you have those mastery skills, as I explained prior, the various masteries which are there for the HR manager. Then you have matching people with their jobs and organizations, right? So right fit between the job and the person. Okay, I always say a person will remain in the organization only when there is a tight fit between the job and the person, or job and the candidate, and the candidate and the organization. There should be a fit. So candidate should match for the job as well as candidate should match for the organization culture. Then only the candidate will stay for a longer time in the organization. So that's very, very important. So you have to match the person. You have to put the right person in the right job at the right time in the right place. Okay. As well as the person also should fit with the organization culture. Okay. Apart from that, other issues, there are a lot many other issues like, you know, grievances of the employees. Okay. All these are various challenges which do come in when it comes to HR department. Okay. I hope it's very clear for you all. Moving on to importance of HRM, my dear students. Okay, so here we could see the importance of HRM at various levels. So first we look into social level. Okay, so when it comes to social level, the proper management of personnel enhances their dignity by satisfying their social needs. Okay, so if you have really a good HR management in organizations, okay, that time you enhance the dignity of the employees by satisfying their social needs. So if you have a better HR practices, HR policies within the organization, obviously your employees will perform better. When your employees will perform better, the productivity will be good, as well as the growth of the organization will be good. When the organization grows, automatically the employees also will grow in terms of money. Okay, so they'll be getting better salary. When they get better salary, they can live a better life. So their standard of living increases. So that's what we say, the social level. So this can be done by taking following steps. Okay, so what the HR can do, okay, when it comes to social level, forming a balance between job available and the job seekers according to the qualification and need for the organizational criteria. So how can you, improve the standard of living of the society where your organization is located? First is you have to form a balance between jobs available and job seekers. Okay, so you have to create jobs. You have to be a job creator, okay? As well as you have to give employment opportunities to the people within the society. Apart from that, you need to look into the qualification as well as you need to match the needs of the organizations, okay? Apart from that, giving the organization suitable and the most productive employment, you have to give the right candidate to the organization, which brings psychological satisfaction. As I said, person job fit, person organization fit. So that if it is done, you have a satisfaction. Okay, then utilizing maximum resources in an effective way. So it is not only the human resource which is being utilized here, the natural resources, the land, okay, or the technologies, whatever it is. You see to it that as a HR manager, you utilize the things in a proper way. Okay, you frame the processes in such a way that you utilize it in a nice way, okay, in an effective way. And also pay the employee a reasonable compensation, okay, in proportion to the contributions which have been made by him or her to the organization. So compensation structure should be fair enough, okay, and should be very competitive enough. Then it you can also put forth reducing wastage and improper use of human resource. You can see to it that the skills of the human resource are being utilized to the fullest extent and you do not waste the skills of the human resource which are there in the organization by having a lot of conversations or conservations of their normal energy and health. Okay, see to it that you do not overdrain the people in your organization. Okay, you do not take too much of work from the people in the organization. You just have to have a balance. You have to strike a balance. Then afterwards, you have assisting people to take their own decisions that are in their interest. Okay, giving too much of giving the freedom for the employees, counseling the employees. All these are various things which are being done by HR department at social level. So as you say, importance of HRM at social level is very high. Apart from that, importance of HRM at the professional level. Okay, why HR is important at the professional level? We have seen why HR was important at the social level. Now let us see why HR is important in a professional level. So here, crediting healthy working environment, teamwork in the employees is promoted. So here, if you have HRM in your organization, HR department in the organization, or best HR managers in your organization, you can have a professional level which is being built in your organization. So how can this be done? Basically by forming the dignity of the employees as a human being. Okay, you look into the human resource in the organization as assets of the organization. Now that is first thing which is to be looked into. Apart from that, you give better dignity to the employees, you give better designation to the employees, better pay to the employees, and also give maximum growth opportunities to the employees for their development in the organization. Apart from that, build healthy relationship between different departments, different work groups, okay, so that they perform better within the organization, enhance their skills and capabilities by training and development opportunities, career planning. Apart from that, rectifying the errors of wrong postings and proper reallocation of work, everything. So it doesn't mean that HRs do not do mistakes. They do the mistakes. So rectifying those mistakes. All these are the importance of HR department to be there in the organization. If it is there, these all things can be done at the professional level. Apart from that, at the individual level, why HR department is required? So it helps in accomplishing the goals of the organization. And also, this can be done by adopting following measures, okay, by taking certain steps, making right attitude among the employees through effective motivation. So HR is continuously in communication with the employees, okay. So HR department people will be training the employees, they'll be speaking to the employees, okay, they'll be building a rapport with the employees. So that there, what they do is they build the attitude, that is right attitude or positive attitude towards the organization within the employees, which ultimately motivates them and makes them loyal towards the organization. And that's the importance of HRM. Apart from that, making effective use of effectively the human resource, what is there? Okay, so HR department will be having the skill sets of the employees. They know which employee suits for which job, okay, where you can utilize various employees, okay. So that can be done. So whenever there is absenteeism in certain departments, you can put forth some other departments. So HR department will be knowing whom to be put forth there to make the work done. All these are various things which can be done by HR department. Then tying willing cooperation of employees for achievement of the goals. So cooperation of the employees can be secured only if you have the right leader in the HR department. Okay, so that's what we say, the importance of HR department. Then at the corporate level, when you speak about importance of HRM at the corporate level, okay, it helps the business. Okay, HR is being seen as a strategic partner of the organization. So when I say strategic partner of the organization, they become the business partners in the organization. So here, they help business organizations to attain its goals and objectives more efficiently and effectively in the following ways. Okay, so they ensure that business organization has a team of dedicated, competent employees. Okay, so here, as I said, HR is the heart of any organization. So HR works well, then organization works well, because the employees, okay, employees are the reason for the success or failure of any organization. So who will be recruiting these employees? It is the HR department. So here it ensures that it put forth the employees, or recruits the employees in such a way that it builds the team of dedicated, competent, okay, people in the organization. As well, utilize the human resource within the organization. That is one of the ways through which it helps in attaining the business goals and attracting and retaining the employees talent, okay, from the market. Getting the best talent from the market. So if you have HR practices and policies in such a way, then in a great way, in an innovative way, 100% you have the best talent which will be there in your organization. You can attract the best talent within the organization. Apart from that, retain the talent in the organization by various policies, practices, promotions, and all those things, right? As well as developing required skills and correcting the attitude of the employees through proper training. That is one of the things which is being done, as well as effectively securing the cooperation of the employees and grievance handling. All these are various things that can be done, okay, by the HR department, okay, to gain importance at the corporate level. Apart from that, national level, my dear students, HR plays a very vital role when it comes to development of the nation. So judicious utilization of natural, physical, and financial resources of nation, it requires efficient and committed workforce. As I said, Indian government fails in attracting and retaining the best talent within the market. You have so many Indians who are working abroad, okay, they work for the companies, okay, in their particular countries, but they do not work for India. Why this is being done? Because you are not focusing on, attracting the talent. You are not giving the best package for the employees. You are not giving the better opportunities to the employees, to the talent which is there in India. So that's the reason they just think of, flying away from the country and get when the ground is being given in other countries, they just go and work down there. Okay, so that should not happen. So that is one of the importance, as I said, at the national level. If you utilize the natural, physical, and financial resources of the nation in an efficient and effective way, you will be having committed workforce. Now, people from India will not go otherwise into other states, into other countries, right? They will be in India. If they are given right opportunity, 100% they will work for India, and obviously the nation or economy grows. Apart from that, the second thing which can be done is economic development of nation is dependent upon skills, attitude, and values of its human resource. Okay, so here the Indian organization should build the culture of the organization in such a way that they utilize the skills, they build positive attitude within the employees, and they build better values within the human resource of the organization. That if that is done by the HR department, then you have growth at the national level. Okay, India can be from an underdeveloped country to a developed country. Okay, then it aids to accelerate the process of economic growth. As I say, and it assists the help in it assists in a help improving the standard of living and better employment. Obviously, when you provide employment opportunities, when you give better compensation, you are building a better society by building better standard of living to the to the people, okay, and then giving better employment opportunities to the people. That's the reason Modi government started with work in India, okay, make in India, so that more of the organizations are being created in India, employment opportunities are being generated, and then you have better economic development of India. Okay, so that's what we say are the importance of HRM. Okay, then moving on to models of HRM. So these models we'll be seeing in the next class, students. Any doubts still here? Akanksha Gunjikar, any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, am I fast in explaining?
No, ma'am.
Okay, great. Okay, so the video will be shared to you all in the group. I request you all, please watch the videos. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Pooja Patil, Soumishri Maitri. Pooja Patil?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, great. Fine. So let us end this class today. So models of HRM will be looking into the next class. Thank you very much, students.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.